back at some examples. Here are some the examples I showed you earlier. What do you notice about these goals? Look them over. One of the things you might notice is that these goals do have different scopes. The ones on the top are really focused on a specific topic, and the ones on the bottom are really broader across the whole course. So there are these different scales of learning outcomes. You might have what we call learning goals, which are the course broad course level goals. You might have 5 to 10 per course. And then learning objectives are what we call the more specific topic level learning outcomes, and there's usually 2 to 5 of those per topic. So the important thing about these core skill goals and these topic level objectives is that they should be consistent with each other. They should be aligned. Here's an example from astronomy. So one of the big course goals I might have is that I want students to interpret simulations and data. It's a big take-home message. And then when I'm in a particular unit on the phases of the moon, I might have them analyze the phases of the moon by using computer simulations. And that's a way to help students get at that broader course goal by doing something within that specific topic. So let's look a little bit more specifically at the course scale goals. What does it really mean to have a course scale learning goal?
For me, a learning goal is something that you want students to be able to do at the end of the course. So typically it's very ambitious, encompassing, and really is often driven by a question that is the entire course is organized around trying to answer.
Like maybe think about what a student would remember from your course 5 years from now. What would they want to talk to their friends about? Let's say you teach introductory astronomy or introductory biology. What would they be excited to talk about with their friends or family 5 years from now? That's what I think of at the level of a course goal, something big and broad that communicates that they've learned something about the discipline as a whole.
Now for a particular topic, as I said, you might have just a few learning objectives. Here's some more about learning objectives.
And then the smaller goals are the various things that you would need to do and know in order to actually meet those larger learning goals and answer the course driving question.
For an objective, I think one has to focus on the outcome that you expect the student to be able to do. So if you think about, you could imagine an exam question you might have written where you'd be asking the student to compare and contrast something or to explain something or to analyze a figure. And I think if you think about what you would want to actually assess the student on, then that helps you write the objective because the objective is tied to the assessment.
So I've got a question for you. Which of these on this list are appropriate topic level learning objectives? There might be more than one. This is a bit of a tougher question, so give yourself some time. So let's look at each of these in turn. So this first one, using 4 while loops to solve problems with repeating actions. I'm not a computer scientist, but I can imagine in a course learning about 4 while loops and, you know, a couple of class periods or something like that. And it's a nicely articulated goal. So I'd say that's a topic level learning objective. So A is. What about B? Recognize the importance of statistics for scientific research. I think that's bigger than a particular topic. That's something it would take several different units to get to. So I don't think B is. C, given a reaction at equilibrium, write an equilibrium condition using partial pressures. Sure, that would probably be in a unit on partial pressures. D, compare and contrast the types of environmental impacts associated with different mineral extraction techniques. That one, yeah, that seems like it would probably be in a unit on mineral extraction and geology. So, and then E, apply knowledge of work in Newton's laws to calculate energy consumption in common transportation systems. I don't think that's something you could get to in a single unit, so I'm going to say that that's not. So I'd say A, C, and D are the topic level learning objectives. Here's another question, same list. Which of these does not really fall into the category of course level learning goal or topic level learning objectives? This one's even trickier, so give yourself some time. So our choices here are B and E, right? Because those are the ones that were not topic level goals. So recognize the importance of statistics for scientific research. That looks like a nice clear course level goal. I could imagine getting at that through several different topics. But what about E? Apply knowledge of work in Newton's laws to calculate energy consumption. That's a pretty big goal. If that was where the goal ended, I would say that's probably a good course level goal. But then it says in common transportation systems. So it's got this really specific context for that broad goal. So it's this weird hybrid of a topic level and a course level goal. So to me, E is the sort of fuzzy one that doesn't really fit into either category. You could argue with me on that, but that's my thinking on it.